all this mainly was to teach others, you know, how to survive on their own and not to rely.
Dr. Alice Mwesigwa started a dairy farming project in 2010 after her husband was made Bishop of Ankole Diocese. She named her project Mwesigwa Farm. The vision to start the project was to create a center for training Christians, mainly women and the youth, to start income-generating projects in their homes, preferably farming. Mwesigwa naturally had great love for cows. She grew up in a cattle-keeping family, practicing free-range type of farming. When her husband became bishop, she felt it necessary to have cows around them. Besides using the project as a training center to empower Christians, Mwesigwa also realized that being a wife to the bishop, there would be many visitors to their home, and she had to be prepared. Buying milk would be a challenge without their own farm.
So I said, why don't we have a cow instead of buying milk? Because we're frustrated when we're in Kampala, I would buy milk and it's, you know, diluted, contaminated with some other stuff you wouldn't know. And I had, you know, little children. So I said, no, I can do it. And that's how I started 2010.
Mwesigwa started the project with one cow, gifted at the consecration of her husband. She convinced her husband to keep one cow at their residence, but he wondered how that would be possible.
With one cow, which was given to us by late Bishop George Tupesigwa, he gave Bishop Sheldon a cow. I said, no, you see, this cow came from the bishop, let it keep here. Because the rest, we took them to the farm. So I started with that, but by the end of the year, I had brought another, so the project increased, but that's how it started. I've never regretted why I started this project, because personally I've gained.
The project has become a model farm. Pastors' wives and community members visit to acquire farming skills. Currently, she employs 12 people, both at Mwesigwa Farm Ruharo and at the village farm. Farm institutes send students to her farm for internship.
When we are having meetings or conferences annually, talk about this project, and they come here and they say, and some have started. And also the youth, when we normally have youth conferences, and when we are here, we talk about it. I say, come and see what I'm doing. I'm educated, I have a salary, but alongside that, this is what I have. And I think it is a challenge to many. And also jobs too, especially like these people who are doing internship, they come over here and creating jobs for.
Mwesigwa has set up a system that ensures smooth operations even when she is not at home. Being a wife to the bishop, most times she travels with her husband, but the workers she leaves behind keep the business running well. Among the challenges is lack of market for her milk and poorly skilled workers.
For we take on. Some are not committed. They work when you are there, so when you are not around, cows, you find the trough is dry, it's not clean. So that's one of the biggest challenges. And then sometimes some people coming on lacking the skill. You see, these people these days, they want money, but they don't want to work. I don't know where this attitude will end. You want to be paid, but he doesn't want to work. So some people actually, this very cow you see, it has a problem. The eyes were affected by some people I had who didn't know what to do when you ask.
Some of the beneficiaries we talked to hailed Mwesigwa and said the farm has helped them access good quality milk.
We have been able to get good milk that helps us to feed our families, especially us who have young children. We have really benefited a lot, and we have learned.
Her milk is very different. It is very conk. At times I would even put it somewhere and get ghee out of it.
In zero grazing, I work with it, but it needs time. An animal in zero grazing, it needs more time. At that time, you have to care about a cow like as if you care for a human being. To produce or to get her yields.
Report by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.